Good morning, students. Today, in this video, I will teach you the poem I Cannot Remember My Mother, written by Rabindranath Tagore. We will complete the poem in 2 days, and in all these days, you should read the poem again and again. Revise the text thoroughly for better understanding. By the end of the poem, you will be able to explain meanings of difficult words as used in the poem. Explain the poem in your own words. Write down the central idea of the poem. And you will be able to understand the piousness of a child-mother relationship. Now let me tell you something about the poet. The poet Rabindranath Tagore is one of the India's greatest poets, composer of the Indian national anthem Jana Gana Mana, and the first Indian to receive Nobel Prize in literature in 1913 for his collection of poems Gitanjali. Now let's discuss the summary. I Cannot Remember My Mother is a nostalgic poem. Tagore's mother passed away when he was very young. Therefore, in the poem, he expresses his inability to recall the face of his mother. The smell of flowers triggered the happy moments he had spent with his mother. He could only recall the tunes that he shared with his mother in happy moments. He is able to hear those tunes when he looks at his toys. He adds that he could feel his mother gazing at him from the sky when he looks out of the window of his room. Now open your English literature book, Roots and Wings, at page number 128. Poem, I Cannot Remember My Mother. Now let us read stanza 1. I cannot remember my mother, only sometime in the midst of my play. Midst means middle. In the midst of my play means mere khel ke beech mein. A tune seems to hover over my playthings. Hover means floats in the air. Playthings mean toys. To hover over my playthings means mere khilonon par mandarane ke liye. The tune of some song that she used to hum while rocking my cradle. Hum means to sing, rocking means gently moving, cradle means a baby's bed or cot. While rocking my cradle means मेरे पालने को हिलाते हुए. Now, in these lines, the poet says that he could only recall the tunes that he shared with his mother in their happy moments. He is able to hear those tunes when he looks at his toys. His mother used to hum those tunes while rocking his cradle. Now, I will teach you how to write explanation with reference to the context. Stanza 1. First of all, we will write down the hint outside the margin line with the pencil and we will underline it. For writing down the hint, we will write down the first 2 words of first line of stanza 1 and last 2 words of the last line of stanza 1. So the hint will be, I cannot dash dash my cradle. Next, we will write down reference to the context. It will again be written outside the margin line with the pencil and we will underline it. In reference to the context, we will write down the name of the poem and the poet and what does the poet want to tell us. These lines have been taken from the poem I Cannot Remember My Mother, written by Rabindranath Tagore. In this poem, the poet expresses his inability to recall the face of his mother, whom he lost in his childhood. He says that the things in his room remind him of her. Now, after writing reference to the context, we will write down the explanation. We will write down the explanation outside the margin line with the pencil and we will again underline it. Now, you will write down the explanation as discussed. Now, let us read stanza 2. I cannot remember my mother, but when, in the early autumn morning means Sharad Ritu ki jaldi subha mein, the smell of the shuli flowers float in the air. Shuli means name of a flower, floats means moves, in the air means hawa mein. The scent of the morning service in the temple comes to me as the scent of my mother. Scent means sweet smell. Morning service means morning prayers or rituals. In the temple means mandir mein. As the scent of my mother means meri maa ki khushbu ki tarah. In these lines, the poet says that though he cannot remember his mother, but the smell of shuli flowers floating in the early autumn morning and the smell of morning prayers remind him of his mother's fragrance. Now let us do explanation with reference to the context of stanza 2. Stanza 2, first of all, we will write down the hint. It should be written outside the margin line and it should be underlined. For writing down the hint, we will write down the first two words of first line of stanza 2 and the last two words of the last line of stanza 2. So, I cannot dash dash my mother. After writing down the hint, we will write down the reference to the context. It will again be written outside the margin line and we will underline it. Children, remember, for writing down the reference to the context, we have to write down the name of the poem, the name of the poet, and we have to tell what does the poet want to explain. So, these lines have been taken from the poem, I Cannot Remember My Mother, written by Rabindranath Tagore. In this poem, the poet expresses his inability to recall the face of his mother, whom he lost in his childhood. He says that the things in his room remind him of her. Now, after writing the reference to the context, we will write down the explanation of the poem. Explanation will be written outside the margin line with the pencil and we will underline it. Now you have to write down the explanation as discussed. I hope you have all understood the topic. Now do the explanation of stanza 1 and stanza 2 along with the reference to the context on your fair copy. Thank you.